I'm Sandeep Khosla.
And I'm Mahbu Jani. Welcome to our show.
Her husband has the nation wrapped around his little finger, while she has him eating out of the palm of her hand. She's a television and a film producer. She plays a queen to her husband, the king of Bollywood. She's a closet interior decorator and a super mom. She's also a style icon for women across India. Please welcome our guest for today, the one and only Gauri Khan.
Gauri, thank you for being on our show, and it's a pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Gauri, so tell us, you and Shah Rukh are totally self-made. It must be an incredible high to achieve so much at such a young age.
Absolutely. I mean, it's amazing, and we thank God every day for whatever we have. But I think Shah Rukh is extremely hardworking, and so he deserves every bit of it.
But you stood like a rock behind him, like you're like a pillar behind him.
But actually, that's not true, because I was not too happy about him coming to Bombay. And actually, I didn't even know when he became a star. Like, it was like, it was very shocking for me, firstly, to be here and films and everything. It was very, very difficult. And I actually didn't want his films to do well. I thought if they flop, I should go back to Delhi.
Delhi.
Because, you know, when you're so young, and I got married when I was 21, and films and what happens and everything was so new that for me it was like, no, nothing should run and everything should flop, all his films should.
But God obviously answered your prayers, darling. He just became the biggest superstar. When you're self-made, it's a whole different
satisfaction.
I'm sure you enjoy every little thing that you people buy or you.
But it's been actually very gradual. At times, like when his films did well, what had hit us, I was not even aware of what was happening. Like, you know, when his first film did well.
Do you remember the first film that did well?
Exactly, that's what I'm thinking.
Deewana.
You know, I was like, for a second. So you just forget. And Deewana did well. And before we knew it, it was Dilwale and all his other various big films. And it was amazing. Like, I didn't even know that he had become such a big star. It was like that.
But when did he tell you that he wants to conquer Bollywood?
Has he conquered it?
You know, okay. We are saying he officially can conquer Bollywood. So
yes.
What
well,
do you have to say?
I think he still has to conquer it further.
No, that's wonderful.
No, I don't think there was a thought behind it. He was always ambitious and always, actually from his very childhood, in his school, in his college, he's always been on top, whether it's his
he's a fantastic student as well.
Student, his football, hockey, whatever he touched, his theater, anything. For me, whatever he would touch would be gold. I think I was smart to marry him. I think that's my smartness, that I chose the right guy.
I think you just loved him too much. That's the other thought of it.
As I said, I'm lucky to have him, you know, even today. So.
And he's lucky to have you.
There's not even a question.
But you all met quite early in, almost in the teens.
As I said, like, he was the first person I met and went out with. So.
And he's been the only man?
Yeah, absolutely.
Fantastic. In this day and age? Fantastic. What happens when you guys go to parties sometimes, I'm sure, and you have this wonderful blonde bimbit dancing with Shah Rukh, and sometimes you have this fabulous hunk dancing with you. Who gets more jealous? Who gets more possessive? Who reacts which way?
I think Shah Rukh dancing with somebody, I would say, well done.
He loves dancing, doesn't he?
I'll say, well done. You've gained confidence. And, if I was to dance with somebody, I don't know. Depends, actually, on who the person is.
Does he ever react or doesn't ever react?
Of course.
Immediately.
Of course, immediately, yeah.
And how do you react to this Queen of Bollywood tag? Aren't you fed up of it or aren't you embarrassed of it?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, what Karan did to me at Z Awards, I don't think I can ever forgive him for that.
I share that thought with you.
Because it was so stupid. I mean, Karan did it very sweetly and yeah. Sajid did
it.
It was fun for them, you know. So it was quite sweet of them to do it. And they said that, you know, the sponsors wanted it like that. But I was very embarrassed and I didn't know where to look. But it was because it was Karan, it was fun, it was a joke for me. But I think...
You would have beaten up. Yeah, anybody else would have just beaten them up.
That would have been just a bit much, I think.
Shah Rukh is this big media person. He is all over. And you're always so shy and you're not in the media and you're always in the background.
It's not the question of being shy. It's not that I'm media shy or anything. But I just feel that if you're not in a profession to just, you know, be... I mean, you have to talk about something to be in the press, you know. It's fun to do a fashion shoot
true,
like that.
Yeah. And you have
but
been on cover,
unnecessarily,
so.
You know, talking. And after a point, there's nothing much to say. That's my whole thing, you know.
Gauri, in India, Shah Rukh has done pretty much everything. I would think it'd be wonderful if he goes to Hollywood. What do you think?
For me, I'm happy with whatever. If today he says that I don't want to act, I just want to be... you know, be a director or a producer, that I'd be fine with whatever he's happy with, you know. It's
you don't want to push him and go
not
him
at
into,
all not yeah. at all. I'd rather have him home with the kids, spend more time at home.
That's fantastic.
That would be better for me, I think.
So tell me, Gauri, you come from a close-knit Punjabi family, so how was your childhood like?
Very basic, simple, middle class. My father was in the army and then he became, you know, got into business, exports.
So you traveled a lot if he was in the army? You traveled a lot?
No, not really, because by the time he retired, by the time we grew up, and my mother is like a general in the house, and we grew up actually with my nani, not my father's, but my mother's side of the family, my mama, mommy, my brother, so... and my masis. Okay. So it was...
She had a full-on nani.
Yeah, like a full-on, like, hum aapke hain kaun. Absolutely.
You know, it's been written about in the past as well, that you and Shah Rukh had to fight to be together.
Yeah, I mean, my parents were obviously not for it, you know, because so young, and then to take a decision to get married, and a person who's going to join films, and being... from a different religion. The most
I believe
important.
His name was Abhi.
Yeah, Abhinav. He changed his name so that, you know, they feel that he's a Hindu boy. But that was really silly and very childish.
Your mother took it easily or?
No. It was very, very hard for them. Very hard. Because coming to Bombay and a new life and a new profession and, you know, those days were like, totally different. I mean,
but it must have been fantastic to be, you know, be doing exactly. You just didn't follow any rule. You just left everything up one day, left from Delhi without anything and following a man with a dream.
It's been an amazing journey, I would say. Just amazing. Like when I came to Bombay, it was very difficult. I mean, I enjoyed every bit of it, but it was so new and life was so different and new people and new place and a new home. And
how did Shah Rukh help your homesickness? And
as I said, I mean, we went back very often to Delhi, you know, in the beginning, because obviously you know, surroundings were so new and people were so new.
Did you have an apartment? You bought an apartment or you just rented a place?
Yeah, Mr. Aziz Mirza, we stayed in his place for 6 months. That was very sweet of him to do, you know, to give us his place. And then we rented an apartment and we didn't have, there was nothing, and my mom came from Delhi and there was no bed, there was no sofa, there was no chair, there was nothing, there was just a kitchen. Yeah, it was like, even, I mean, it was a, she was shocked to see me like that. She said, but why don't you have a bed? Where is the chair? So I said, this is a gadda, sleep on this. So she said, but that's really stupid, you should go and get yourself some furniture. So I said, no, now we're going to move out. We're going to move out next month and you know, then we'll buy everything. That took us a year. So for 1 year, we were drinking water from patilas and sleeping on gaddas. This was in Mount Mary.
And today your mother must be so proud of you that you own the hugest house in Bombay with the most spectacular view, and you run it up so fabulously. What did she say today? What is her reaction to
you? Actually, it's been so gradual, actually. Yeah. You know, everything has been starting from a rented house, then to buying a small flat, then to buying Mannat, which was very, very gradual. So it's not that it was overnight that we bought this place. So she's also grown, you know, seeing us from like no chairs in the house to then a flat with furniture, then to a home, then to a building. So it was all very, very, you know, slow and steady, I would say.
You know, Shah Rukh lost both his parents at a young age. I mean, I think when he got his first award, his mother was no more, if I'm not mistaken.
That's right.
I mean, you must have had to play so many different roles.
Yeah, actually, that's what has made him such a sensitive person, even today with his children. That's why he's very into, I mean, all parents are into their children, and all fathers, I'm sure, are very involved with their children these days. And but for him, it's like, losing his parents at such a young age that he wants to give he spoils them to that extent, you know, that he wants to give them everything, you know, spoils them rotten completely. And he's.
And what do you have to say when he starts spoiling them?
I can't do anything, you know. I just have to sit back and just complain, like, can you stop, like a complain box all the time. That's what Aryan calls him. Mom is always complaining, you know.
So do you remember, once in a while you both sit together and remember the days gone by?
Yeah, of course, but I still don't feel, I just feel that life is just starting, you know.
True.
So it's always like something new is happening. So we go back to those days, you just feel that, God, that was like a million years ago.
I'm sure you remember the day Shah Rukh bought you your first diamond.
I bought it myself. I grabbed it, actually. I'm quite a grabber.
That's wonderful.
He doesn't have to gift me anything.
Welcome back. We're in conversation with the wonderful Gauri Khan.
Now you all are an ideal couple, but today how do you perceive yourselves?
Actually, I would say our relationship has, you know, been over so many years. It's also, we've grown up together, you know, married young, and then he started working. He's been working for the last 15 years, 18 years, and I've grown with him. So our relationship has, it's only like, till today I feel I'm getting to know him. It's very strange, but till today I'm discovering him,
which is a success of a relationship.
A few months ago I was telling Karan, I said, you know, I've just discovered this about him. And I can't believe it, that after so many years, I didn't know this about him. So I think a relationship is always growing every minute, every
second. That's a wonderful thing you've said.
Yeah, and I don't think any relationship, whether it's a child with a mother or a father, husband, anything, it's always growing every minute, whether it's...
It can't stagnate. Moment it stagnates, then
it's over. It's and that's over. What marriage is about.
That's true. And what about the kids? How do they react to this father who's in the paper every single day? And saying something wilder than the last.
But right now they're not looking at the papers.
Okay.
You know? Mm. And they're not watching TV, like the news and stuff. Actually, they should be. But they're still small and still young. So, yes, of course, they're aware of
that. How old are they?
Aryan is 11 and Suhana is 8.
You know, you come from a Punjabi background. Shah Rukh comes from a Muslim background. So... How do these different faiths mix?
When there's Diwali, I lead the function, the puja, I lead and the family follows. And on Eid, I think Shah Rukh would lead and we would follow. And I think it's all very beautiful and the kids accept. In fact, my children are more inclined towards whatever Shah Rukh would say because, you know, But of course, for them, Diwali, Eid...
It's all the same.
All is fantastic.
It's absolutely wonderful. You know, as parents, we tend to forget our own history sometimes. What if Suhana comes with an out-of-work struggling actor and says, Mom and Dad, I want to marry him.
Shah Rukh would catch hold of him and make him sit and bore him to death. He would ask him so many questions and teach him how to act, and he would get fed up and run away.
He'd become a headmaster.
I think he would just get fed up and say, oh, this person.
And what if Aryan got a wannabe actress?
Oh, that's a tough one. I don't even want to think or go there right now.
You say, gold digger, get her out of here. No.
I don't know. I think I would have to accept whatever my son wants to do. I mean, whoever he wants to marry. Right now, I know it's very easy to say it, but I would accept, I mean, it would be.
You know, you are considered one of the most luckiest women in Bollywood because your man is completely faithful to you. What's the secret?
What should I say? Or is he hiding a few things which we don't know about?
Has he given you any diamonds recently, unexpectedly?
Or does he keep secrets well? No, there is no secret behind it. I think...
It's you. You have the magic wand in your hand. Obviously, he loves you.
I would
you.
Like to believe that.
Perfect. We believe you. We are some of your friends. Your friends want to ask you a few questions.
Okay.
And here they are. You're going to have to answer them.
Gauri, I hope you're having a great time at the show. Now, my question to you is that if you were marooned on an island, if you were stranded on an island, who would you rather have with you, me or your husband?
You, Karan. Absolutely. I mean, there's no choice here. Absolutely you.
And why?
Because... Karan would always keep me entertained, like 24/7. It would be like watching a film, you know.
So what, you'll be gossiping about people, starting a rumor?
Including my husband. He'd be the first one we'll attack.
And I think we have another question.
Gauri, this is a question for you. It always amazes me. How do you manage to cook so many dishes whenever there's a party? And matlab, I know that there's so many vegetarian, non-vegetarian dishes, and you must be slaving the whole day in the kitchen cooking for us. And after such a hectic lifestyle and looking after the children and then getting ready and looking so glamorous, how do you manage to cook all these dishes I want to cook?
Actually, मुझे बचपन से ही दाल, सब्जी, आलू, गोभी बहुत शौक था.
बनाने
बैंगन अपने हाथों से आटा गूंदना मुझे बहुत ज्यादा शौक है. So Farah, that's my answer.
Is Farah cook it all, or she doesn't know how to fry an egg?
No. Farah and myself, we had a cooking, like a dessert making competition once, and she came with this really fancy dessert, which is like mousse and this and that. And what I did was I got hold of 3-4 other dishes from everywhere, like desserts, and made it so beautiful and glamorous that I won the prize. So she was fuming and she said, like, how can you do this? So I said, well, I wanted to get the first prize.
You know, your friends, a lot of your friends say, you know, Gauri is incredibly chilled. She just doesn't give a damn. Is that true?
I give a damn about myself.
Absolutely. You look fantastic. You have to give a damn about yourself.
Yeah.
And
no, it's just my nature, I guess.
We're going to get to a wonderful segment now, which is Hooked, Booked and Cooked. Who hooked who?
Okay.
Between the two of you. Who booked?
Is there a question?
Okay, he hooked you. And who booked? He booked.
Yeah.
And who's getting cooked?
Oh, you can ask him that.
Welcome back. We're in conversation with the wonderful Gauri Khan.
Gauri, sometimes we have some secrets and we share them, and sometimes we keep them to ourselves. So it's confession time.
Okay. What I used to do,
yes.
I used to pinch people under their you know, under the seats in the school, like really hard, and they would scream, and the teacher would wonder what's going on, and it was me, with a pencil, like really hard.
And pinches hurt very bad.
Pinches and poking pencils.
And it just keeps those pencils sharpened, obviously, all the time.
Absolutely, so that I can just be mean.
And what else?
And various other things, like jumping the school walls and running off with Shah Rukh for a date.
Okay. We need some more in any case. We're going to get to us. We're going to do love, kiss, kill.
Okay.
One thing of somebody you'd love to love in a confession. Somebody you'd like to kiss.
Kiss and tell, and then I should say it on national TV.
Yes, kiss and tell, you can tell. Yeah.
So that's what I'm saying, not at all. And kill, I want to kill y'all.
Why?
Because I'm here. Giving the interview.
That's, you have to kill, you know, Shah Rukh.
I'll sort him later. Right now, it's y'all.
So, confession time is over. She's not the easiest confessor, but we got at least things out of
something.
Her.
Yes.
Now we come to a really funny part. And we're going to ask you some quick questions. And let's see what you have to say. Which is the most overrated virtue?
Being faithful.
Gauri Khan ko gussa kyun aata hai?
At Shah Rukh's bad timings.
Is marriage overrated?
Not for me, not at all.
Complete the following sentences. The secret of a good marriage is?
I think space, giving each other space.
The one thing that can ruin a marriage is?
Snoring.
Possessiveness is?
Possessive about my handbag. Extremely.
Fame is?
SRK.
One night stanza?
Too short.
Infidelity is?
I would have no clue.
What's the one thing you absolutely hate about him?
He spoils the kids rotten.
What do you fear the most?
Losing my close friends and my family.
And what does he fear the most?
He has a dream that one day when he wakes up, he may lose his arms.
What's the one thing you love about being Mrs. Shah Rukh Khan?
All the attention I get.
And what's the one thing that you hate about being?
The questions asked by various people. Like wherever I go, I feel people have a question mark. Like when they see me, they have a question about Shah Rukh and I want to run. Like 100 miles away from that question. Where is he? Where is he? That question, like,
it's
haunts
very,
me.
Yeah.
You know, just where is he coming, or is he on his way, or...
What's the longest amount of time you've been apart from each other?
18 years.
Apart from each other?
Yeah.
Okay.
Then the film, and he's been working for 18 years, yes, and he's been working, I think, 18 hours a day.
What's the one thing you love doing together?
Watching Desperate Housewives. He loves to watch that with me.
What is his favorite character? The woman who's poisoning her husband? Or?
That one. And he thinks that's me. Eva.
That's true. And what's the biggest character difference between you and Shah Rukh?
He's unstoppable.
True.
And I'm unmovable, if there's any word like that. I'm lazy as hell. And he's absolutely super energetic.
Now it's time to play Who's the Boss?
Okay. So clearly I'm the boss.
You are the
because
boss.
Because I'm going to have him right here on this show with us.
I don't. That's a surprise.
Yeah. I've made sure he takes time off and he arrives.
Yes.
How do you want to call him? We have a great surprise here. Mr. Gauri Khan. Sorry, Shah Rukh Khan himself.
Good to see you guys.
Good to see you.
Hi, how are you?
It's a surprise.
Hi, Gauri.
Hello.
You can give me a hug.
Okay.
This is incredible. How have you managed to do this?
See, I told you I was the boss.
So you just have to snap a finger.
Absolutely.
And he always appears.
Most of the time.
Then you cannot complain that he's not been there with you for 18 years.
No, I can't.
She snaps her finger and I only appear if the sofa is so tight. If it's a big sofa, then I don't come.
So that's love. Get snug.
Yeah, as long as, this is the way it is, yes.
So Shah Rukh, we are going to play Who's the Boss.
So let's go, so we have to answer these questions.
Some questions.
All right.
Yeah. Who remembers birthdays?
I do.
She does.
Who decides a family holiday?
I do.
She does.
Who starts a fight?
We both do.
I don't. She does.
She does.
No, we actually don't have a fight. It's been many years I've known her. I never fight. We never fight. Maybe we don't love each other as much. Because people tell me, if you don't fight, then you don't love each other. But I think we never fight. I hate to fight unless we can get into fist fights.
Okay.
And that I don't do, of course, because I lose.
But that time management, if he fights with me, there's no time to make up because there's no time in his life. So,
you can't
time management is what I would call it.
So we don't fight.
Who sets the rules?
I try to, but I think...
He breaks them.
Totally.
No, we don't break them at all. We just sort of, just bend them a bit.
Every single time? For the kids only or for?
No, just for the kids, yeah. We like it because, she doesn't like dogs coming into her living room, etc. And so we like the dogs to come and pee on the sofa.
Small the little beautiful.
Things. Small little things like that. Because, it's important that the whole household should feel oneness. So the kids think the dogs are the most important. So we need to give them that space and allow them to pee on the sofa once in a while.
Once in a way.
Once.
But dogs, if they do it once, then they want to do it again.
Exactly. It's habitual.
Who never forgives and forgets?
I have a bad memory, so...
She doesn't remember only, so it's okay. I think I'm not...
And do you forgive?
No, I don't think I'm important enough to forgive anyone.
Who controls the bank accounts?
Rajaram, our accountant.
He controls them, she signs, I work for the money.
Oh, God.
It's all sorted out very clearly in the house.
Who decides the menu?
Farah decides the menu. Gauri gets it cooked and then we all eat it.
He eats it.
In the bed.
Who gives the better presents?
He does. I have to admit. I only buy myself things selfishly.
What's the best present she's ever given you? Don't say herself.
Huh? No, I don't think so. She's never ever given me a present.
I think that's just wonderful.
Many a times she gives it and she says, actually, I got it for me. And it looked nice on me, like a watch or something.
Okay.
A couple of times she's given me handbags, which haven't really gone well with the clothes I wear. So I've rejected them and she's taken them just because nobody was using them.
Who's more romantic?
Looking at me? It's your show. I the only reason I've come on this show because somebody told me it's about wives. So I thought, you get it right, that's why I'm here.
So it's me.
So my husband's more romantic. Yeah.
How often does he advise you on things?
All the time.
And do you take his advice?
Yes, I do.
And how often do you advise him?
I advise him, but the advice is not always taken. Though he pretends as if he's going to take it.
Shah Rukh, what's your take on this?
I don't know. I don't advise her ever that way. Because to be honest, she doesn't really do anything. But she does take my ideas. She doesn't do anything that is related to my line of work.
Okay.
But that's the only advice I can give because I think that's sort of expertise that I have. But like if she has something, she'll show it to me. And 99.9% of times, I just turn around and say, it's really beautiful. Because I really believe, because I don't have much taste in good things and,
You got her.
Like I said, I don't have much taste in good things. Looking good.
Not at home.
That's wonderful.
Absolutely clear.
Darling, you are the boss.
I'm excited to get this crown. This crown I would love to have.
Welcome back. Shah Rukh, now that you're here, we may as well ask you a few questions.
Please do.
What's your relationship founded on? Love, friendship, lust?
I think a bit of all three. Because you know, when we are discussing relationships, then we try to demarcate them and say, Is it X? Is it Y? Is it Z? But I don't think it works like this. I think it's a little bit of, so I'll say 33 and one-third lust, 33 and one-third love. And on the degrees vary on different days, depending on what kind of sofa you're sitting on. It's like that.
But with success and with work and with so much of, involvement.
It's like, let me spell it out. How you have to see it, it's like when you have a child and you don't realize that the child is growing taller, the outsiders do. So I think relationships are like that. You don't know how they're evolving. They must be changing, I'm sure.
Yeah.
But the outsiders can tell. When people ask me, have you changed over the years? We say, no, not at all. It must be happening to all of us. Physically, it's something that happens. Have you changed your hair? And you haven't. You're just losing them. So you don't realize it, but it happens over time. So relationships are like this. I think they must be changing. We don't realize it. We still feel we came to Mumbai 18 years ago, 19 years ago, and we still go back one day. We just got married. Just by the way, we've got two kids. We've got these two kids. We've got them. Yeah. So we don't know. We've never really. When I don't know if Gauri said this when she came from Delhi, there was this whole attitude that we are just here for a while, and we were too young.
Yeah, she actually said she was shocked at your first film that became a hit.
Yeah.
She was saying, not a hit, we want to go back.
Yeah. It's like, I was praying, okay, I hope this doesn't work.
She was like that. So we didn't even know what we were doing, how serious it was.
Yeah.
And strangely, the first time I was in this same studio when I got to know I've got a hit film. It's 20 years now, or 18 years ago. And I was like, is that...
And she didn't remember the name of the film?
Oh, okay. But then you can't blame her. I've had so many hits.
Do you think kids change the equation of a marriage?
Not at all. I think... what?
I think they are a manifestation of the romance or love or friendship or lust or whatever you call it. So they remind you of that, I think. I see a bit of Gauri in one of the babies. I see a bit, I'm sure she sees a bit of me in the babies. And it's sort of, how do you say it? It just personifies what is actually an intangible thing. It's love and XYZ. But I think it's sort of personified. It's like, this is love. this is marriage. This is relationship. And mashallah, we have two very good looking relationships.
Do you look back at the simple times when you all came to Bombay or in Delhi and...
No, I don't miss them. People ask me this question very often. I don't miss going and having chaat in Gold Market. I don't mind, I've never wanted to eat pav bhaji on chapati either. I'm very happy being a star. I love what comes with it. I also appreciate the hard work that I have to do for it, and I don't want to wear dark glasses to hide from the world that I'm a superstar. And I really enjoy it, and I think we are very thankful and grateful for the fact that we are a big star family.
You didn't want to be famous ever. You're famous by default, but you're enjoying
it's an extension of...
But she does believe, I don't know if you say it, but she does believe that she's got undeserving attention. And I really appreciate the fact, she's very comfortable being who she is. I'm not. I like to be Superman one day, Batman one day. I want to be Om one day. I want to be Shanti one day. So I've got issues with myself. She doesn't have any issues with herself. She could be Shah Rukh Khan's wife, the superstar's wife. She could be Manmohan's wife. She could have been anyone. She's comfortable
she
being
herself.
She could
have been Manmohan's wife. After the way you courted her and the way you chased her,
there was no
choice for her.
Yeah. if Manmohan had done the same. But I'm just saying she could have been... what is nice is she's her own person. Which I'm not. We are quite loggerheads at about that. I need to be someone else every morning. She doesn't need to be anyone.
Would you like, we asked Gauri right at the beginning of the show, that you guys came from Delhi to Bombay, no great fortune, no...
Like you?
Absolutely. Very
few people know this. We've done theatre together,
absolutely.
By the way.
So, she said it's been absolutely brilliant. The whole journey has been brilliant.
Yeah, it's been really nice. I think you can't ask for more. You have to be very grateful to Allah, to God, to Bhagwan, and say, this is really nice. There is not one moment in our lives, at least I feel so, maybe Gauri feels differently. And I think that's what a relationship is about, that we have freedom and space to think differently. But I think things have panned out really well. I just happened to be in the right place, right time.
I want to just ask you one really corny question. You know, when kids are born, usually, you know what I mean? The first relative, I'm sure your mother went and said, she looks just like Gauri. He looks just like Gauri. And your friend must have gone and said, he looks like Shah Rukh. How did you both react? You just given birth.
Actually not. When my daughter was, when we had Suhana, and I was like desperate that she should look like Shah Rukh, you know. So when she was born, we were just staring at her and I was just telling her, I hope she looks like you. I hope she looks like you. So that was really amazing that she got this dimple.
Yeah, queen, you know, she saw the child.
And then she was brought out and she had this absolutely little dimple. She really does look.
But
like
I it's very strange thing about our kids is they're clones. You know, they're like Dolly. They're both clones. My son looks just like Gauri, even to the extent, you know, Gauri has a little bump behind the ear, and even he's got everything. Yeah. And my daughter is a complete replica of me, and it's very strange. So we would never, as a matter of fact. Every day I'm hoping people tell me my son looks like me, and I'm sure Gauri hopes people say, you know, but they're just complete clones, and my son hates it because he doesn't want to look like a girl.
Yeah.
My daughter also obviously would like to look like her mother, not like the father. So if anybody said that, you know, when Gauri's mom saw Aryan and she said, "Ete bilkul Gauri haarega," you could not have denied it. He looked like Gauri, you know, and really, I mean, the kids look just like both of us. They're like clones if they, when they grow.
Are the characteristics the same or?
No, absolutely no. Different actually, no.
Aryan's like you or?
Yeah. Looks like me like and behaves like him.
Okay.
Gauri looks like
best of both.
And Suhana is the opposite. Suhana behaves like you and looks like you.
Yeah.
Does yeah. She? No, she's also started. We are trying to turn around to behave like me and be a better person.
Mr. Humble himself, no?
Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.
And Shah Rukh was a wonderful surprise. So thank you for that also. We have a small surprise for you. And if you follow us, and Shah Rukh, you can come with us also.
Oh, but the surprise not for me at all.
It's not for you.
You don't expect it.
Oh, yeah.
Your
yeah?
surprise will follow.
Oh, yeah.
But Gauri, because she's clearly is the boss, so we have to give her the prize.
Oh, it's a prize. It's not a surprise. Yeah. Okay.
It's a surprise.
It's a surprise prize. Okay.
Let's go to reveal your surprise.
Come on. And thank you very much for having me on the show, both of you.
Welcome. And thank you so much for coming on the show.
Wow, sorry for me.
Oh, it's beautiful.
I think that does a bit of it. Yeah. It was really nice. Huh?
Stunning. Thank you.
Welcome. You're welcome.
Do I at least get the blouse to wear?
You'll get something home.
Thank you.
It's been absolutely fabulous today because you had a huge surprise with Shah Rukh himself coming here to support Gauri. And Gauri has been absolutely sensational. Please do tune in next week. Watch The First Ladies with Abu Sandeep. See you till then.